Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I'm going to show you how to use Visual Studio Code for creating Spring Boot projects. So in my previous videos, I have showed you how to use Spring Tool Shoot for Eclipse. This time I'm going to show you how to use it on Visual Studio Code. So I'm going to create a Hello World Spring Boot project on Visual Studio Code, and I'm going to also run that on browser and console. So it will be a web application. So by the end of the video, you'll be able to successfully create your very first Spring Boot projects on Visual Studio Code. So to watch the video till the end, I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things. And if you're still facing any issues in middle, you can always ask me on comment sections. And I'm also on Instagram now, so you can also follow me over there. And you can ask all of your doubts over there as well. I'm definitely going to help you. So now to use Visual Studio Code for creating Spring Boot projects, it is very important to have Java installed on your system. So for that, you can always watch this video to know how to install latest version of Java. Once you have Java installed, you are good to start with Spring Boot projects. So let's verify whether Java is installed or not. So just simply go to search and type cmd to open your command prompt. And within command prompt, if you just simply type java space dash dash version, and just simply hit enter, you can see that it is showing that latest version of Java is already installed on my system. So if you are getting this type of prompt, then all that basically means is your Java is rightly installed and you are good to start creating your Spring Boot projects. So first you will need Visual Studio Code, so just quickly install it. So just go to your favorite browser, open a new tab and just simply type Visual Studio Code, hit enter. So let's click on the first link to download our Visual Studio Code. So download it, and it is rightly started downloading, and it is downloaded also. So just simply click on the installer, accept the license agreement, click on next, again next. So it's going to create a Visual Studio Code folder, totally fine, next. Check all these options and click on next. So install. So our installation is rightly begun, and it is rightly installed also. So our Visual Studio Code is installed, click on finish. So minimize our download directory as well, and our Visual Studio Code is rightly started opening, and it has rightly opened. So this is the interface of our Visual Studio Code. So now you both have Java and Visual Studio installed. So it's time to create a Spring Boot project. So for that, you need to install a couple of plugins. Just go to these extensions and just simply search over here Java. So that will show you this Java extension pack. So it is developed by Microsoft, so it's going to install all these different extensions. So just, you know, simply click on this install, so it's going to start installing this entire extension pack. So it has total 7, you know, extensions, and all are rightly started installing. You need to have active internet connections also, and you can see that all of our extensions are rightly installed, right? So once you have extension pack for Java installed, next thing that you need to install is Spring. So just simply type Spring. So that will show you the Spring Boot extensions pack. So again, it is developed by VMware and it contains total 3 extensions. So again, just simply click on install and it's going to start installing all these different extensions. So you can always click on trust publishers and install. And because it is developed by VMware, so it is the same thing what it is showing over here, right? So when you click on this, so this extension pack, Spring Boot extension pack, is what we are going to install, right? So you can see it is actually started installing, and again it is developed by same VMware. Just wait for a couple of minutes, and there you go. So you can see all of our extensions are now directly installed. So you can, you know, close this tab, you can close you know, this welcome note as well. You can close this welcome note also. You can go to this explorer and you can click on this create a Java project. So that will open this drop down over here. Here you need to select this Spring Boot. So just simply click on that. That will show you what type of project you'd like to create, whether you'd like to create a Maven project or a Gradle project. So mostly developers use Maven project, so I'm going to select that Maven project only. And here I'm going to specify the Spring Boot version. So the latest version is 3.5.0. So I'm going to select this 3.5.0 snapshots, and that's going to show you what language that I'm going to use. So here you can choose Kotlin and Groovy also, totally your wish. I'm going to select Java, as that is what mostly developers use. So I'm going to select Java, and here it is telling to provide this import group ID of our project. So, you know, let's change this example to something like Geeky Script. All right, and just simply hit enter. And now you need to provide your artifact ID. So let's give the artifact ID as Hello World, and again hit enter. So now it is telling what will be our package type. I'll again going to select the popular one, jar, and this time it is asking to provide a Java JDK version. So as you know that I have installed Java JDK 23, so I have showed you also that under command prompt. So I'm going to select JDK 23, which is the latest version also. So when you click on that, that's going to show you this drop down, which shows all these different type of project that you can create. Alright, so you can see it is, you know, really a very long list. So you can select, you know, as per your project requirement. You can also, you know, start with no dependencies. So it will be just a standalone application. But I'm going to create a web application. So I'll just simply type web. So that will show you this Spring web. So that will include RESTful API, then Spring MVC architecture with Apache Tomcat as a server. So all the things it's going to have. So I'm going to search with web, and I'm going to select this Spring web. So when you select that, it will show you that that is selected. Now you need to just simply hit enter, and that going to, you know, open this the folder location. So it'll ask you to provide the folder location. So I'll go to desktop, and I'm going to, you know, create a new folder, and I'm going to name this folder as spring-workspace, and I'm going to select this folder, and I'm going to click on generate into this folder. So immediately you will see that it will directly start generating, and successfully generated location is this. So it is directly done. Just simply click on open, and that's going to immediately open your project Hello World right on your Visual Studio Code. You can always click on this I trust the authors and all. So you can see that it is directly opened over here. So when you click on this pom.xml file, you can clearly see that it's going to use this latest version of Spring Boot, that is version 3.5.0 snapshot. And here is our artifact ID, which is also our project name, and version is also we are starting off, so it is 0.0.1. and this is our project description, and it's going to use latest version of Java, which is Java 23. All right, and these are all fine. You can see the group ID, artifact ID, dependency. It is a Maven project, and you can see that it is a web application, right? So Spring Boot Starter Web. So now if you expand this src folder, and if you expand this main, you will get a Java folder, and there we have, you know, this Hello World application.java is rightly created over here, which where it also contains a main method. So if you write something over here, so let's write something like system dot out dot println, and within colon if you just simply write something like Hello World, just end with a semicolon, you can see that it is actually done. So when you run this, it's going to show you this Hello World on your console. All right, so you know, before running this program, let's create a controller class and, you know, run our project on our browser as well. So let's first go to file and save this file, and let's create a new file over here, and let's name this file as, let's say, Hello World. Okay, I'll follow the, you know, naming convention. So Hello World controller dot java, hit enter. So our Hello World controller.java file is actually created over here. Here, you know, let's first give a annotation of our class to REST controller. So just simply hover over this and click on quick fix. So that will import our REST controller, and also let's import our package as well. So just simply click on add a package declaration. So our package is also now directly added. So you can see all of our errors are now directly gone. Next, you know, let's create a method called, let's say, public string, and give our method name as hello world, and let's return something like awesome welcome to Spring Boot. Just end with a semicolon, and let's also add one annotation of request mapping. So just simply click on this, and let's provide our path as well. So this is what it's going to be, our browser path. So just save this file and just simply click on this run button now. So you need to click on this project over here, and you will see that it is actually started building. You need to, you know, provide permission to firewall. Just hit allow, and there you go. You can see that our project is rightly builded. You can also click on allow over here just to provide permission. Yeah. So you can see the output already coming on our console. So that is our console output. So whatever we have written over here, this hello world, so that output is properly coming over here. Along with, if you just go to your browser again and open a new tab and just simply type localhost colon 8080 then slash hello. All right, hit enter. So immediately you are getting the output coming on your browser, right? So whatever you have written, so basically if you see this controller class, so we have given our request mapping path as slash hello. So that is what we need to type over, type it over here, and you are getting the output whatever we have returned over here, a very simple string value, right? So awesome, welcome to Spring Boot. In this way, you can easily use Visual Studio Code for creating Spring Boot projects, and you can start working on your Spring assignments. So that is basically all about this video. Don't forget to subscribe our channel Geeky Script along with Geeky Syntax. So here also regularly I am posting lot of coding related videos. So don't forget to subscribe this channel, and also if you are interested in learning WordPress, you can also watch all these different videos on our channel. So you can basically watch this entire playlist. So some videos are 1 hour, some are 1 hour 30 minute video, some videos are in series. So you can watch all these videos on our channel for completely free. Alright, so don't forget to watch my other videos. And lastly, special thanks to the supporters of our channel. We are truly grateful to you guys. Supports like this really motivate us to create and improving these videos. Again, thanks a lot for being an essential part of our journey. So that is basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.